my black people. It's all about the unity. It's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
Warning. Stand by for countdown. Prepare audience for maximum impact. Full immersion begins in.
I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Up 7 easy. There's a reason why after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuffin' Up 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody wanna get in a beat with Angel Snuffin' Up 7. But you don't take me seriously.
Free your mind. This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. And this time I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am. 'Cause it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
My Negroes don't have. If I'm gonna die, I'll die now, right here fighting you. If I'm gonna die, you my enemy. My enemies are white people, not Viet Cong or Chinese or Japanese. You my opposer when I want freedom. You my opposer when I want justice. You my opposer when I want equality. You won't even stand up for me in America for my religious beliefs, and you want me to go somewhere and fight, but you won't even stand up for me here at home.
No, I don't worry. I'll tell you, I'm a man who believed that I died 20 years ago. And I live like a man who is dead already. I have no fear whatsoever of anybody.
Seems to me that white America must see that no other ethnic group has been a slave on American soil. That America freed the slave in 1863 through the Emancipation Proclamation, but gave the slaves no land. And at the same time, America was giving away millions of acres of land in the West and the Midwest, which meant that there was a willingness to give the white peasants from Europe an economic base. And yet it refused to give its black peasants from Africa, who came here involuntarily in chains and had worked free for 244 years, any kind of economic base. And so emancipation for the Negro was really freedom to hunger. And when white Americans tell the Negro to lift himself by his own bootstraps, it's a cruel jest to say to a bootless man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps.
Saying that the Nation of Islam should evolve into what we call the Reality's Temple on Earth.
Throughout the history of the United States, the construct of racism was created specifically to oppress black people, to try to suppress our determination to achieve liberation. Like Angela Davis said, it's built into the system.
Nowadays I can't believe what's going on in front of me. I don't want to watch TV and find another casualty. I don't want to read the news. My heart's already black and blue. I'm putting on my combat boots, 'cause I got an attitude. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry black woman?
We can't successfully put an end to racial discrimination until we change the entire system.
We've been trying to keep the peace 50 years since Martin King. Some don't like me for who I am, but I love my melanin. Another future college grad sleeping in a body bag. Mother screaming out her lungs, she never gonna see her son. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore.
Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry black woman? Oh, hey, yeah, I'm angry. Hell pissed off.
Tell me, how long will we run? Or will we hide?
Cause we're losing young ones. Hands in the air, we keep praying for a miracle. Cause every day is a struggle. But as long as my brothers and my sisters are in trouble, you're damn right, I'm a ABW.
Let's get this party started quickly.
Thank you. begins in 3, 2, 1.
Okay. What we want to talk about? What we want to talk about? Well, of course, just by the title, it will upset a lot of folks. Just the title upset a lot of folks because we can't accept the reality of things. But it doesn't make any difference what you upset, what makes you upset, as they say, or I have heard, it is what it is. Oh, by the way, if you don't know me by now, I am the mighty, mighty, mighty. Angel Snub Nub 7, of course. Welcome to another spontaneous broadcast of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth. I'm not going to be long. I always say that and end up an hour, but we don't want to be long. The topic that we chosen is, why is white power, or rather, why is white unity greater than black unity? Woo! That's the question. First of all, unity has no color. It is not black, it is not white. It has no color. We put color, or we identify it with color, or that's something that we unify upon, but unity has no color. Unity is simply those who come together for a specific purpose or belief. We are a unified family. I'm the husband, there's the wife, the children, we are unified as a family. Family unity. We are unified as drug dealers. So we have a gang. We're going to make our money in prostitution and drug dealing and all kinds of crime. We are unified in crime. Unity has no skin color. Unity is just those who come together to support a specific activity or a ideology or belief. That's all unity is. It has no skin color. In this case, we want to unity. We unify because of the supremacy ideology that I'm better than that race. I'm better than you. So we unify because I believe I am better and greater and smarter. We unify under this ideology, this belief. How has it been working out for y'all? Supremacy. How has that been working out for you? It has not been working too good for all those who are involved. I was watching the news last year. We're going to use this as an example. And there was a battle, or the Congress could not vote, they could not come together on a Speaker of the House. And the first person, I don't know these names, so the first person they thought was a shoo-in, and it took hours and hours and hours, and he finally got in. Next thing you know, before he could even get started good, he was voted out. Africa, or wherever. You've never united. You've never come together on a point. You've never done that. They get together and they accomplish. They don't have to like each other. And they have proven it over and over again. And they don't have to unite because of white. They unite because of whatever that ideology. They have the ability to unite to accomplish something that benefits everybody or this group. You don't have that capability. Because it's all about you and what you want. Personally, clearly, these don't want black unity because it's easy to do. It's not difficult, it's easy to do. You don't want it. You're selfish. You're arrogant. You're a know-it-all. You think you don't need nobody. So if you don't need nobody except God, I don't need nobody except Allah, what the hell you asking, buddy? Why you keep messing with folks? If you can do it on your own, do it on your own. Leave people alone. Stop trying to convert people. Stop trying to mess with folks. Do it on your own. Black unity cannot happen without the black. And you don't really like the black. Because they eat pork. Because they go to church. Because they drink a little liquor. They smoke a little weed. Because they're not a vegan. Because they don't like the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. Whatever your reason is. These people in this nation, regardless, they're liberals or conservatives or whatever the hell these names they come up with. They find a way, enough of them find a way to come together to take care of business. You can't do that because you're too damn childish. Unity, when black unity has not done a damn thing. You can't unite to do it. It's never, there's no such thing as black unity. The reason why the African continent now and then, the reason why it's in the condition that it's in, because there's no unity among them. Even though they all understood the threat, they too damn dumb to come together to unite against a common enemy. Yesterday and today. And you want me to be some kind of African when the African is too damn dumb to unite against a common enemy, to unite to solve a common problem. So you have somebody like the daughter of Dr. King, who is a Christian pastor, she's reporting on what's happening in the Sudan. But the Pan-African, like Dr. Umar Johnson, never talk about the civil wars and the starvation on the continent of Africa. He wants to paint a picture of how lovely everything is. Dr. King's daughter, Bernice, asking folks to think about and reach out to help those in the Sudan, the Congo. You don't hear these Pan-Africans and these pro-black, blackity black, you won't hear them talk about let's unite to help those on the continent. They ask you for donations to help them. Help me build my school. Help me pay my utility bill. That's what you get from them. That's what you get. So I'm on here talking about these things. Is it my fault? Am I wrong? This shows hypocrisy, because being a hypocrite or hypocrisy is being something that you're not. You really don't like Africa like that. It's a belief system. You don't know them. So you cannot relate to their suffering. You can only relate to this delusion, this Black Panther, Wakanda stuff, your imagination in your head that don't exist. You can't even afford, the majority of us can't even afford to go to Africa, because they're not going to give you nothing. And the price of living is far higher than it is here. They cannot even help themselves. You keep talking about the resources. The white man and the Chinese people, whatever, they're stealing our resources, the resources of Africa. What's the sense of having resources and you don't know what to do with it? You don't know how to get it. You don't know how to use it. You ever heard the old saying, one man's trash is another man's treasure? I know I've thrown out many things on the trash, and then I look out, it's gone. What was trash to me, or something I couldn't use,
talking about not falling into the teacher trap, not falling into the website trap. So today, what teachers can you learn from? We just told you that the Aka Wu tells you that we're all a great teacher at the same time. So who are you going to learn from? You're going to learn from brothers like Sarnetta. You're going to learn the positives and negatives from brothers like Sarnetta. You're going to learn the positives and negatives of people like Brother Polite. The positives and negatives of people like Sarah Sutton Seti. You're going to learn from Maurice Muhammad, Talik Ibn Rad. You're going to learn from Neder Cat. You're going to learn. You definitely going to learn from King Noble. You definitely going to learn a little something something from Brother Daku.
Yes.
saw it on the trash, got it, and who knows what they made it where it's useful. They were able to use it. So what's the sense of Africa having oil, diamonds, or whatever, gold, and you don't know how to get it? So it's just like you having nothing. That's why they allow these foreigners, that's why they allow these other people to come and do what they do, because they can't do nothing with it. And then they give them a few scraps. You know, you help me dig this up, I'll give you a couple of dimes and nickels. Otherwise, you wouldn't have nothing, because they don't know what to do. They don't know how to refine uranium. They don't know how to do these things. And you don't either. You want to go to Africa for the resources. You don't know how to do it either. You don't know how to drill for oil. You don't know how to dig for diamonds. You don't know how to dig for coal. You don't know how to do nothing. You put on this show. Where are your skills? Where are your nation building skills at? You don't have none. But you know about what happened 5,000 years ago, and you a history buff. You don't know how to build a house. You don't know how to build a car. You don't know how to build a road. You don't know how to get electricity. You don't know how to do nothing. The real knowledge is the skill in building and getting the necessities of life. All this other stuff is leisure knowledge. It's leisure stuff. Building houses, of securing the necessities of life. And you can't do that. We do know a lot of things, but we could know even more if we was unified, but you're not interested. But you put on this show like you're interested, because that talking that kind of way makes money for you. You're not really about that. White unity also protect money. It has not always been good for all white people either. But they unite enough to take care of business, where they can support their whiteness. You can't support your blackness. Your blackness is nothing but a bunch of talk. Hallelujah, high glory. That's all your high glory is. Black unity is nothing but church. Is that my fault? That's not my fault. And there's no argument. To argue this point makes you look like more of a fool than what you really are. Black unity, there has never been black unity. The closest that you have to black unity was a few rebellions, slave rebellions. And of course, they brag about what happened in Haiti. But overall, it has done nothing. You don't have the mentality. You don't know how to unite for a common cause that would benefit the whole. You can't do it. Every month, they say, over 200,000 immigrants from South America are coming across these borders. Some will be deported back home. Many will be here illegally. They will be here. Within the next 5 years, you're going to be begging them for a job, because they're going to be able to unify themselves and move up the ladder. And you've been here almost 500 years. And let's be fair. You've only been off our ancestors. We've only been off the slave plantation for a little less than, 200 years now, going on 200 years or whatever. But we're going to have people that just come straight over the border, and you're going to be begging them for a job. Your children going to be begging them for a job with your black unity ass. How embarrassing. That's embarrassing. But if that's what you want, keep doing what you do. You only hurt yourself. You don't hurt me. I'll be dead soon enough. You don't have to worry about listening to my voice. You don't hurt me. You hurt yourself. You hurt your children. You put them in this hole. Out of love. We should know better than that. You keep talking about black unity, but you're not interested. These folks only want to push their agenda. And you can do that. But like Donald Trump said, we have not learned the art of the deal. The art of the deal. I'm not talking about the art of war because you're too damn scary to go to war with nobody. I'm talking about the art of the deal. In order to be able to deal, you have to learn how to compromise your body involved. You're happy. They're happy. Everybody's happy. Or satisfied. That's good enough. I'm cool. The art of the deal. Wow. It's a waste of time to argue. I can be wrong, which I know I'm not. Bring the proof. I don't see the proof that your black unity is greater or equal to white unity or anybody else. Your condition says it all. And many of you have an attitude. You don't have to like nobody. You can come together with people. We don't have to like each other. But what is it that you want? What is it that all of us want? Let's get together and go get it. You don't like everybody at your job. But everybody comes together to get the job done. And you see the product roll off the assembly line by people who don't even like each other, but you come together for money. You unify because of money. I need a job. And these cars come off the assembly line. These people that y'all listening to, they're not doing you no good. They're not causing you to produce. They're not causing you to think clearly so that you can get a job done so that you can produce. Because believe me, once you're able to produce, you're going to get more. You get so fired up. And then you begin to re-examine some of the things that you believed in. Like, damn, I don't need that. Look what we're doing. We're finally producing. Black unity is no longer just words. It's power. Unless you earn it. So I'm not going to talk about soul power. I'm not going to talk about black power until you earn it. Until we earn it, it's just words that only make you feel good and nothing else. On that note,
because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
And all this propaganda that you want us to say.
So you're soul brother, number one. In the name of our ancestors, peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I am the gatekeeper, the host of this program, known here on social media. Wherever you may find me, I am known as the mighty, mighty, mighty Angel Snub Number 7. I am your soul brother, number one. Just a quick, spontaneous broadcast. This is the first broadcast of the new year. And I hope that your new year is beginning to be one of the best ones that we've experienced in a little while. I thank you so much for listening to us in 2023. And I thank you for your continued support and listening to us throughout this year. It's about responsibility. It's about accountability. When it comes to others that we don't like, they are not held to that criteria or that level. It's a word I'm looking for. I can't think of it right now. People we don't like has responsibility, and you hold them accountable. But those who we worship, those of whom we love, there's no accountability. There's no responsibility for them. And you wonder of why you're in the condition that you're in. Because we like somebody. If I have a leak in my house and you claim to be a plumber and we have been friends for 40 years, you're my best friend. You come to my house and you make the problem worse. Why shouldn't I hold you responsible? I got a mess on my hand. You told me you was a plumber. You made the problem worse. There's water everywhere. We can't use the toilet. But using y'all logic, because I like you, you say something that makes somebody feel good. They do something that we know that is incorrect. Then we cannot hold them liable for that. That's crazy. Only those with a cult mindset would rise to the level of not holding somebody responsible, regardless of who they are. Because it's a disservice to everybody, including yourself. How do we benefit to let people do the plumbing in our house and they can't do it because we like them? That's your brother. The brother is not fixing the problem. The brother is making things worse. There's water everywhere. But this is our mentality. I don't understand that mentality that we have. I'm very sure I will be the first one, because I have not heard this. I have not heard this from nobody. Especially those who never was in the Nation of Islam. I don't expect them to say anything because they just don't know. They never been in the ranks. But you in the ranks, you who call yourself a FOI, a Fruit of Islam, part of the military wing of the Nation of Islam, past and present, it makes no difference, with Farrakhan, without Farrakhan, it makes no difference. There's a duty to you as a soldier, as there's a duty to the military in the United States or Venezuela or Cuba, wherever you find a soldier, there's a responsibility, because your job is to protect your nation, protect your people from threats, foreign and domestic. That's your job. In the Nation of Islam, you have captain, you have lieutenant, and so forth. Another position they don't talk about Another position is called investigator. To investigate. The brother or sister investigator, their job is to in a timely fashion. I cannot say that word. Periodically. That's okay. Some words got me flim-flam. Their job is in a timely manner, check on the believers to make sure, number one, that we are clean. Because we are taught in the nation of Islam, also in Christianity, cleanliness is next to godliness. So you visit the investigator, sometimes will visit your home to make sure that the brothers and sisters, you're keeping yourself clean. Another job for the investigator.
By Brother Angel Snubnob 7 at the Reality Temple. And to give props to him, because I listen to all of Angel Snubnob 7's videos, I think that he comes from a different angle. And there's a powerful message in a lot of the videos that he put out, and I try to catch all of them. I look at him as a free thinker and a person that's willing to challenge those of which he don't agree with or which he may think differently from, and I really respect him for that. He's challenged KNBS, and he has also challenged the black supremacy movement as well. And I have nothing against that, because that which cannot be challenged cannot stand and will not stand and will not survive the test of time. How many challenges we can withstand will determine how long we will be able to stand.
Himself, and you don't realize it. You don't realize it, that God has been in prison. The devil was able to imprison God. So right inside your own self, your God self has been in prison, and you have a false sense of self running rampant inside the temple. This is why, you understand what I'm saying? You,
yes, sir.
You have to bring Reality's temple here on earth. Reality's temple here on earth.
Yes, sir.
We have to realize the enemy is running rampant inside this temple.
Is to investigate any type of allegations or accusations of those who have broken or may violate the restrictive law. So there's a rumor that Brother Talik, who is not married, is messing around with a sister that's not married. And some hanky-panky going on. So the investigator will bring this up and investigate to see what's going on here. Has there been violation of the restrictive law? And to my knowledge, the brother and the sister who are being accused will be brought forth, taken before the officials, or sometimes I heard you could be brought before the whole, all the believers, or as they said in the church, the whole congregation. You be brought forth. And if you are found in violation, and mind you, if you had the position of captain or lieutenant or whatever it is, your position, even as a believer, is taken away until this issue has become resolved. Now, if the investigation shows that things aren't what they seem, then you continue to go along and you are in the ranks, and the sister keep soldiering and the brother keeps soldiering, and y'all keep doing what you was doing as believers. However, if we are in violation, then there's a punishment. And you could be ostracized from the Nation of Islam, and you have no contact with nobody from 0 to 90 days. And in the worst case scenario, you are ostracized forever. You are ostracized permanently. But the point I want to make is, we have an investigator. And this is fine. This is fine until there's accusations or allegations against the leader. In the past, it was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. In this modern day, it's Louis Farrakhan or whoever the leader of these factions are. But when it comes to the leader, there's no investigation. Why is that? Even before Malcolm X knew, there were rumors in Chicago Temple number 2 that Elijah Muhammad was carrying on with these young women that were his secretary. This was the rumor. Every temple is supposed to have an investigator. And if there's an investigator, it has to be an investigator in Chicago. The job of the investigator is to investigate anybody who may be in violation of the Nation of Islam restrictive law. To my knowledge, I've never heard from nobody that the investigator, when these rumors were going around, it shouldn't even got far as Malcolm. These things should have been made known, or the investigator should have investigated and then given his or her report. But everybody gets investigated except the leadership, who may be in violation. If you're not in violation, investigate me. An innocent person don't care about an investigation. Investigate me. You would think that even Elijah Muhammad himself, or Farrakhan himself, or whoever the leader is, you embrace an investigation. But they didn't. Where was the investigator? If the investigator had done his or her job, then they would have found out the truth. And if the truth was indeed that Elijah Muhammad was in violation, then he is also subject to his post being terminated because he's in violation of the word or that what God instructed. I'm like Eric Muhammad, talk black to me. Elijah Muhammad was just a messenger. And even according to your scripture, there were prophets who were in violation of God's will, God's word, and they had to suffer consequence. So you mean to tell me that Elijah Muhammad or any of your leaders, when they violate, they are not subject to punishment for that violation. What does it say in the Quran or the Bible that if you are a prophet or a messenger of God, you are above being punished for being in violation of the word that God gave you, made you responsible for? What does it say that at? But the little man, the little woman in the ranks, you get caught with a pig foot in your mouth, oh, you're going to kick you out the temple. But here's somebody making babies with young women, young enough to be your great-great-granddaughter, that's all right. Or other things. It is the responsibility of the military, because this investigator is part of the Fruit of Islam. This investigator is part of the FOI. It is the responsibility of the military to protect all, to protect the people from all threats, foreign and domestic. So that means nobody is above the law. Donald Trump right now is catching hell, even though he was an ex-president. He is catching hell because of something somebody believed he did was unlawful. President Nixon resigned because he was not above the law. The president of the United States can be charged with a crime. The Secretary of State, a general in the army, nobody in this country, you will find them in a courtroom for being in violation of the law that many of them swore an oath that you will uphold. But in the Nation of Islam, in all this blackity black stuff, the leaders aren't held accountable or responsible. If the Honorable Elijah Muhammad was found in violation, if Louis Farrakhan is found in violation, they should be removed from their posts. That's the responsibility of the military. And you will see what we call when government, when leadership become too corrupt, you will see something called a military coup. And the leader is forced to go into exile. Sometimes the leader is caught and executed for being a traitor to the nation. There's no doubt to me, but there should be an investigation, because if there really was an investigation, then you would know, not spread propaganda. There's a difference between research and propaganda. What you find coming from the Farrakhan camp and all these factions about Elijah Muhammad, that's propaganda. That's not research. That's not investigation. That's propaganda. They only do enough to support their narrative. That's not investigation. There should be a coup when it comes to these leaders, no matter who you are. And you should want to protect your investment. Some of y'all have invested or did invest in the Nation of Islam for 30, 40 years under Elijah Muhammad, and then you've done another 30, 40 years under Louis Farrakhan. That's your investment. And you should want to protect your investment. also the restrictive law come from God. There's a reason why God gave you the restrictive law. And everybody, nobody is above the restrictive law. And you wonder why you're not successful, because you allow people to keep pulling you down because you like them or they the leader. Even in this country, when the leader, I don't care how much you like them, if under, there's always, in this country, there's always investigations by Congress. There's always an investigation about somebody. How many people last year in this country lost their job as a senator or some congressperson or a mayor because they were investigated and they were found in violation of law? So in this instance, the purpose of the fruit of Islam is to investigate and you protect the interests of the people, foreign and domestic. But you're so in love and you have a cult mindset. Some folks are above the law. So you're talking about freedom, justice, and equality. How do you have freedom, justice, and equality, and some people, because they are the leader, they are above the law? How is that freedom, justice, and equality? How is it equality? No different than in this country, where if you're poor, chances are you're going to go to jail. But if you're rich and you can murder, but if you got the right lawyers, you got the right money, you can probably get away with murder because you got money. That's not equality. But you say, Nation of Islam, you say that we represent freedom.
Everybody who is black and interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for. A change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ebenrod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation. The ability to control your own resources. Your politics. The law. Be able to do your own thing for a change. Create an economy. Create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign. some justice and equality. For who? But the leader, these leaders can do whatever they want. That's not equality. It's not equality that the leaders live lavish lifestyles and the average brother and sister gotta hustle. That's not equality. In the nation of Islam, it says you should want for your brother what you want for yourself, and we're supposed to share. Who are these with the that's living these lavish lifestyles? Who are they sharing with? What little brother and sister in the ranks are they sharing with? I know when I was in the ranks, nobody gave me nothing. And they saw me working for the cause 24 hours a day. Nobody gave me a dime. It's all a facade. It's not real. Why you want to continue doing this? Why you want to continue living this fake lifestyle? Some folks are better than others. I'm going to say this and we're going to get out of here. I saw a post on Facebook where Louis Farrakhan was talking about being unique, being original to yourself. How are you being unique and original to yourself? And then you talk about, I am Elijah Muhammad. I am Malcolm X. I am Louis Farrakhan. How the hell are you unique and original when you talk about, I am Farrakhan, I am Elijah Muhammad? That's not original and unique. And then when you do express yourself in the blackity black, pro-black community, and you show that your talent or what you know is just as great, if not better, than the leader. Oh, you want the messenger seat. You want to take over Farrakhan's seat. You want to take over Eric Muhammad's seat, whoever the leader is. And you only expressing yourself. That's what happened to Malcolm X. He trying to take over Elijah Muhammad. He think he better than Elijah Muhammad. And so what if he is? Elijah Muhammad or any man can only take you so far. How do you know that Master Farah Muhammad is not sending Malcolm instructions to his mind? How do you know? You don't know that. You say that the answers to your prayers come from the womb of a woman, but then when she gives you the answer to your prayers, you want to run around and kill the baby. Because that ain't how it's supposed to go. How do you know Angel Snub Number 7 is not the answer to our prayers? How do you know? Well, you're not a Muslim. You're not blackity black. Because the answer to your prayer is supposed to come in the image and the manner that you believe. When somebody is in bad shape and you want to be saved, you don't care what that image is. When you're in a house on fire, when the firemen come in, you're not tripping on what do you look like. Are you a woman or a man? Or you as transgender? You don't care. The only thing you don't care about the vessel. The only thing you know, you're in a fire. And this fire and smoke is threatening your life. Here come the fire person. Help you get out of the fire. Y'all crazy as hell. Because that's should be your concern. There's nobody that's offering us a realistic option than us. Nobody. And they won't challenge. They will try to mock us, dress me up in a Santa suit, but they won't challenge, bring what they talk about is the solution. They won't challenge us. Come here, I will come to you, give us your solution that you got from 1930, that you got from dead people, Marcus Garvey, Frederick Douglass, whoever the hell it is, that you got from dead people that's no longer applicable, that did not work for them. What make you, the hell make you think that it's gonna work for us now? And you keep talking about the ancestors. And some of you say that your ancestors are reincarnated in us, the new. How do you know I'm not that? To bring us the solution once and for all. Aren't you tired of this ring around the roses crap that we go through? This devil versus God thing. It just go round and round. Never stops. It never stops. You do yourself a disservice when you put people so above yourself, they can't be touched. Then they touch your daughters. These old men touch your daughters. And these old raggedy men exploit our sisters. You don't have a dime in your pocket. Talk about polygamy. And you can't even take care of your damn self. And she's brainwashed and give this polygamist her welfare check. She might go out to work. This supposed to be man. Can't take care of himself, but he's a polygamist. Elijah Muhammad took care of all his children because y'all paid that for him. He didn't have a business. He didn't have a job. But the average person on the street helped me pay my child support. Negro, go get a job. Well, tell Elijah Muhammad, tell Farrakhan, tell all y'all leaders, tell them to go get a damn job. And some of them you give money, they still don't pay child support for the babies they got. Oh no, I'm not talking about Umar Johnson. And some of these suckers got lots of women and still want to molest children. I ain't talking about Brother Polite. I'm not talking about Brother Polite. Y'all want to keep falling for the old okey-doke. Everybody. Nobody is above being held accountable. Responsible. All these teachings need to be held accountable. You making claims, God gonna do this and blah, blah. Well, do it. Let's see it. You don't get angry at me. You the one telling the damn lie. You claim that you can do this and you claim that you can do that. And folks give you millions and thousands, millions of dollars. This is 2024. Y'all been talking all this bull doo-doo on YouTube since 2005. What has all this blackity-black, pro-black, African, whatever you want to call it, what has it produced since 2005? That's not my fault. And it goes on and on and on and on. Then when somebody like me, hey, this got to stop. And then I just tell us what the obvious is. You're not. Oh, you are agent. You a coon. No, the agent and the coon
are the dumbasses you wasted your money and your time going nowhere. There's a dumbass Pan-African who still can't get over crap that happened 2-3 years ago. Ask him what he's done during that period of time. What has he produced? He ain't produced nothing. He damn sure didn't go back to Africa. His happy ass is still right here with us. That's where he's at. He's done nothing. I told a young brother that I was investing in, this man is jealous of you. He want to be able to do what you do, but he got to go in his own pocket. You don't have to go in your own pocket. But he didn't believe me. And so now the young brother don't have nothing. And this Pan-African sucker is happy he don't have nothing. And all y'all are happy with nothing. With dreams. What we used to do. We used to do this. And it wasn't all that great. If you go back talking about what you used to do, it wasn't all that great. The civil rights movement produced more that we benefit right now, and this is a fact. You might not like Jesse Jackson. I grew up in the era of Jesse Jackson, and y'all talk a whole lot of crap about Jesse Jackson, but it was Jesse Jackson that continued to hold up the banner. And y'all black and black folks was doing nothing. Louis Farrakhan was able to come get the national spotlight because of Jesse Jackson. Even though he had thousands of people all over the country, the national media didn't pay him no attention until Jesse Jackson was dumb enough, because he probably was seeking some type of brotherhood, dumb enough to ally with him. When you go look at the old sitcoms like Good Times and the Jeffersons, they talk about Jesse Jackson and the Rainbow Coalition. All y'all blackity black folks went on damn vacation. And then I give Louis Farrakhan his credit. It was Louis Farrakhan, his activity, that brought y'all back to life. It was Louis Farrakhan. I know, because I seen the whole thing in real time. You don't know. Most of you don't know. I saw it. I lived it. I saw it. And I give credit where credit is due. And it don't make no difference who you are, including myself. If I take one dime from you and tell you this is what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you I'm doing it. I'm going to show you where your money went to. If I want you to support me, I will tell you that. I want this donation. I want you to help me live. I want you to help me pay electric bill. I will tell you I'm not going to take thousands, millions of dollars and don't produce a damn thing for you just to live good, ride around in limousines and show off, go fly around in planes. Louis Farrakhan went all over the earth and gave you what? The Goodwill Tour, whatever you want to call it. He came back and talked about how they praised him. What did he bring back to you and me? Didn't give y'all nothing. And that's what you love. You love nothing. You're too scared to stand up for yourself. Personality worship. Cult members. With nothing. Then you want to get angry at people like me because I call you out because you're a damn fool. Happy with nothing. Anything these Muslims Whatever they get, you get it on your own. Farrakhan gave me the teaching. The teachers don't tell you how to get something. You learn how to do that on your own. There's people that don't have no God and doing way better than you are at getting something. You're a damn fool. Nobody is above the law.
Good evening, soul brothers and sisters. This is Tangie Cox, the Black Sheep. And I am propositioning you to entertain just a little while of being in reality. And this is gonna hurt soul sisters and brothers because a lot of us cannot accept reality. I empower you to, for 1 year, to subscribe to the Reality Temple on Earth. And at the end of 12 months, draw your conclusion of what have you learned in that amount of time. I empower you. You will never, ever, ever think, feel, or entertain nonsense ever again, period. I would like to see my soul sisters and brothers awaken. This requires time. You need to spend about a year watching, researching, and looking. The Reality Temple on Earth is life-changing, and I stand on that.
That is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
Let's see, Talik says, can you send a shout out to my platform, the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry? Our theme this year is After Purge Comes the Healing. Sub, shout out to your platform, Talik. All the best to you guys with continuing to stretch in perspective, to stretch in what is possible, and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
Peace forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire at Reality's Temple. Reality's Temple. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire.
I keep it real!
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
So, let's get spiritual. Since you allow people to violate God's law, fruit of Islam, then Master Farah Muhammad say, I'm going to take it all away from you. And I'm going to take it away from you again until you get it right. you say the nation will never fall again. It never rose up again. Farrakhan is not Nation of Islam. None of these people are Nation of Islam. It's gone. And you don't need that because this is a different time period. It served its purpose. It served its time. This is your time. This is our time. You murder your new ideas. You make mockery of the new ideas. You know about Kemet. You know about the tribe of Shabazz, but you don't know about your history. You don't even know American history. You talk about slavery, but you really don't know exactly the things that made America as powerful as it is. Yes, it's true. They got a lot of wealth because of slavery. But it took more. There's a lot of nations that had slaves. They did not become powerful like the United States. What was it? What is it that make America as powerful as it is? You know what happened 50,000 years ago, but you don't know what happened right here in this country. And you don't know what happened to yourself. Keep talking about some damn people you don't know nothing about, you never met. You have no respect for yourself and have no value for yourself. You have ancestors that's living who are related to you right now that you know. And you turn your nose up to them. They don't know. They don't know nothing. But then you're going to talk about somebody from 1900, 1875, 5,000, 2,000 years ago that you never saw. If you don't have any respect for the living, how the hell can you have respect for the dead? I'm going to say that again. If you don't respect the living, how the hell you going to respect the dead? Because the dead can't do nothing for you. Who is more powerful? A dead lion or a living dog? You will see the living dog raise his leg and take a leap on the dead lion. The lion was only powerful when he or she was alive. Now that you're dead, the dog come by who's alive can come by and urinate on you. We learn from the past. Don't become the past. You love your mother, you love your father, but you're not them. You're yourself. Nobody knows it all. These leaders, the leader don't know it all. And human beings make mistakes. You fool yourself and you tell yourself a lie. Oh, that teaching is perfect. So-and-so don't make mistakes. You know, that's a damn lie. Everybody make mistakes. And where do you get that from? Because the Holy Quran and the Bible don't teach that. Because the prophets made mistakes. The prophet made errors. God had to put some of his messages, his prophets in check. So what make you think your leaders, they can't do no wrong? You a damn fool because you made a god to them. They're not God. Elijah Muhammad is supposed to be the messenger of God. He's not God. The pastor is not Jesus. You don't even follow your own scriptures. You don't follow your own teachings because you got your nose all up in somebody's backside. And they don't give a damn about you. Many of these big shots, they don't know you. They will shake your hand and forget you the next day. They don't give a damn about you like that. Thank you. Their concern is sending them a check so you can pay their electric bill, their internet bill for them. That's what you do. You don't get nothing out of this relationship. You got to pretend you get something out of this relationship. You got to pretend. You should be sick of this ring around the roses nonsense. Are we that stupid? I said we because at one time I was stupid like that, but I can say this. When it came to my money, that's a no-no. I don't mind selling some bean pies. I don't mind selling some newspaper. But when it came to my money, as hard as money was for me to get, oh no, I'm not. Farrakhan need to get a job. Elijah Muhammad need to get a job. And you should take care of yourself. How you gonna send all this money to Chicago when you have believers? Some of them don't have places to stay. They don't have jobs. You gotta take care of your house. You gotta take care of your own. If you don't take care of your own, how they gonna take care? How can they properly take care of Chicago? If all the members in the temple are doing well, then Chicago can do well. But you give it all, everything that you got, so that you can please the Honorable Elisha Muhammad, so that you can please Farrakhan. They don't give a damn if you living or dead. And some of y'all work for white folks. You don't sell no newspapers. You buy the newspapers and put them in your car. I know because I've seen it. And they still do it. Because some of these brothers and sisters have real good jobs. And they don't have time to go on the street like that. They don't need that quarter. They don't need that dime. They buy the final call, throw them under the house, throw them in the back of that car or something like that. All these newspapers you think getting sold are not getting sold. Or they buy them and they give them away. That's not the purpose. The purpose is for the people to want, to show that they want, they would give you that dollar. You're not supposed to just give the newspaper away. But these brothers, some of these sisters, they making hella grip. And they can do that. But they won't give the poor brother, the poor sister in the temple, won't give them a dime. And you know they don't have nothing. I was 19 years old. Never had a job in my life, basically. Right out of high school, I didn't have nothing. Nobody gave me nothing, including my biological relatives, who were also my brothers and sisters in the faith. They didn't give me nothing either. I was on my own. Oh, but y'all talk all this brotherhood and sisterhood crap. I get in trouble because I give. I used him. If I'm your brother and I see that you don't have, I'm supposed to help my brothers and sisters if I have. That's what I'm supposed to do. Then you help them, they'll turn around. I use Angel Snuff Nuff 7. Well, at least I can get you, because you ain't gonna use these other suckers, because the only thing they do is take. They don't give you a damn thing, and that's who you like. You like the ones that take and give you nothing. I'm gonna raise $1 million and spend $250,000 on a raggedy so-called museum that looked like a strip club, and I'm gonna pocket the rest of it. That's acceptable to you. I'm going to donate to you $1 million to sue Google, and then your case gets dismissed. And so I'm going to buy me a mansion. I'm going to buy me a mansion, swimming pool, a Rolls Royce. That's acceptable to you. So you're going to continue to look like a damn fool. You already been looking like a fool the last 50 years, and you don't mind looking like a fool the next 50 years, you dumbass. You don't get angry at Angel Snuffing Up 7 because you a fool. We deserve better. But you're not going to get better if you don't ask and demand better. You're going to keep getting pimped the way you've been getting pimped for the last 50, maybe even 100 years. Getting pimped. The struggle is an investment, and the investment should pay off. But you so caught up around these personalities that give you nothing. I can't do it. And those who come to this platform, we cannot do that. This situation that we're in needs to end once and for all. And if I can't do it, we're going to find somebody that can do it. I have no problem with saying stepping out the way, because I can't get it done. It's clear. It ain't happening. We got to do it a different way. This is not a cult. So there should have been a military coup if Elijah Muhammad was in violation, regardless to your position, because you violated God. You violated the restrictive law. And it goes to show that the so-called military, the fruit of Islam, is a bunch of punks. You don't deserve no reward, and you got exactly what's coming to you. You're going to sit around and have a party when Malcolm X was murdered, when you should have treated Elijah Muhammad the same way as Malcolm, and you probably would have found out the truth. There was a brother on Facebook who actually investigated and did his research, and he found out that Ola Muhammad was 15 years old when Elijah Muhammad was interacting with her. And he was just like, yo, I don't believe it. Well, now he's done his own research and he found out the truth. What they would have found out when everything was fresh back in the 1960s is up to you. I'm Angel Snubbed Up 7.
And as always, in parting, we wish you...
Come on and jam with us next week on these same stations. And you can bet your last money, it's all gonna be a stone gas, honey. I'm Don Cornelius, and as always, in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul.